Subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah. Subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah. Subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah.
Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, hamdan kathiran mubarakan tayyiba. Alhamdulillah, hamdan kathiran tayyiban mubarakan fi Allahumma. La uhsi thanan alayk, anta kama athnayta ala nafsik. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا ورزقا واسعا وشفاء من كل داء. اللهم أحينا مسلمين وامتنا مسلمين توفنا مسلمين والحقنا بالصالحين. اللهم إنا نسألك حسن الخاتمة أما بعد. One of the greatest, perhaps the greatest muhaddith of this age and of this time, Hazrat Sheikh Maulana Zakariyya, نور الله مرقده. His ilm, his ta'alluq مع الله, his nisbat. He was known even to the Arabs, no stranger to Medina, to Mecca, to the king even, and to the Arabs. Sheikh Maulana Zakariyya, Khandalwi, Rahimahullah. Qutbul Aqtab, the head of the saints and the head of the awliya, is known as Qutb. And Qutb is really Qutb is like the axis upon which things revolve. And the head of the saints of a country, of a continent, is called the Qutb. His title was Qutbul Aqtab, the Qutb of all Qutbs. And titles, the Mashaykh do not give themselves titles. Titles descend from the heavens. Tanzilul Alqabu Minas Sama. Our Sheikh Maulana, Hazrat Maulana Yusuf Motala, has also mentioned Tanzilur Rahma in the Dhikril Abrar, when remembering and speaking about our pious predecessors, Allah's Rahmah descends on that majlis and on that gathering. Sayyidi Maulana Yusuf Motala, Hafizahullah, Damod Barakatuhum, writes about the last moments, the ahwal of his sheikh. He calls him Sayyidi, my Sayyid, my chief, my master, my Sardar, Sheikhul Hadith, Qaddasa Sirrahu, Amin. Last affection. During the last days of the Sheikh's illness, a few days before he passed away, these are during the last days of the Sheikh's illness, a few days before he passed away, a letter from a student of Darul Uloom, Bari, was received. This student from Darul Uloom, Bari, had penned his circumstances and mentioned how he remained aware of his impurities and his shortcomings, and he was conscious of his state, his servitude, and so forth. Sufi Iqbal Ali Rahma read the letter out to the Sheikh in my absence. He expressed great pleasure and said, "Tell me when Yusuf comes. I will kiss his face, tell me when Yusuf comes, I will kiss his face. On my arrival, he said, come here, come here, so I can kiss your face. I leapt forward, our Hazrat Maulana Yusuf Motala, Hafizahullah says, I leapt forward and kissed his blessed forehead and hands. The Sheikh remarked, I called for you to be kissed. I called for you to be kissed. Reading your student's letter, what you looking for, boy? What you looking for? Find it quickly, disturbing, walking up and down. The Sheikh remarked, I called for you to be kissed. Reading your student's letter made me extremely happy. Write to him with lots of duas on my behalf that whoever deems himself as unaccomplished and unworthy, that whoever deems himself as accomplished and worthy is indeed unaccomplished and unworthy. Let him know that. So it's always good to check ourselves and see our faults, our states, our ahwal, because the Sheikh said, tell him, whoever deems himself as accomplished, may bangaya, I have made myself, I have it made now, and thinks he is worthy, he is indeed unaccomplished and unworthy. Conversation with the angel of death, and we are speaking about people of our time, subhanallah, Hazrat Sheikh Maulana Zakariyya, people of our time. His conversation with the angel of death, with Malakul Maut, subhanallah. Hazrat says, a few years prior to his demise, not even sickness of death, a few years before his death, Sheikh Zakariyya alayhi rahma traveled from Saudi Arabia to India. One afternoon, after partaking of the afternoon meal, and after the guests had all left, he rested on a bed in a room of a house built of unbaked earth in accordance to the sunnah taken the Kailula. Opposite him, lying on the floor, was Sheikh Ahmad Muhammad Lulat Karmali from Gujarat, who was the Sheikh al-Hadith of Darul Uloom, Baroda, and Sheikh Mazhar-e-Alam Muzaffar Puri Bihari, the principal of Mahadur Rashid al-Islami, Canada, lay on his bedding. The doors of the courtyard were closed from inside. They were both still awake when they heard the Sheikh conversing with someone. Allah. This surprised them, as there was no one else present in the room. They had only just laid him down and he was still awake. Then again, he had never ever been heard talking in his sleep throughout his life. Not even when severely ill did one hear him groan, subhanallah. Both of them heard the sound of a lengthy conversation, but could not make out the words. As they helped the Sheikh perform wuzu for Zuhar, for Asr now, it's Asr time, they asked him, Sheikh, who were you talking to after we laid you down? Maulana Zakariyya, the Sheikh, threw a handful of water on their faces in affection and love and said, so you heard it, you heard it. He then said, Malakul Maut, the angel of death, had come and I was talking to him, subhanallah. This is a few years before his death. Imagine that honor, that sharaf. We speak about malaika, amantu billah, wa malaikatihi wa kutubi wa rasuli, and he's speaking with Malakul Maut. We read about Malakul Maut. We hear about Malakul Maut, and he met Malakul Maut and spoke with him, lengthy conversation. In fact, let's continue. Hazrat mentions, Hafizahullah, the visit of Malakul Maut, the angel of death, whilst awake. As I began to aid the Sheikh in wudu, coming back to his final days, Hazrat is saying, as I began to aid the Sheikh in wudu during his final days, he asked, "Kaun, who is it?" "Yusuf," I replied. "The angel of death came again today," he said. "The angel of death came again today." I asked whether it was in a dream. He said, "No." Whilst I lay awake, he entered smiling and engaged in a lengthy conversation. This was during his final days now. Our Hazrat, our Sheikh, is aiding him in wuzu. Yusuf, when he is questioned, "Who is it?" "Yusuf. The angel of death came again today." What honor, subhanallah. What ikram from Allah. I asked whether it was in a dream. He said, "Nahi, nahi." "No, whilst I lay awake, he entered smiling and then coming, smiling, subhanallah, and engaged in a lengthy conversation." This was the second visit made by the angel of death whilst the Sheikh was wide awake. Let's go back into time. Hazrat carries us some 25, 30 years back into time. A visit paid by Malakul Maut, the angel of death, some 25, 30 years prior, is recalled by Mufti Maqbool as narrated to him by the Sheikh. Hazrat himself mentions, narrated by Mufti Maqbool, "As an abscess appeared on my forehead in the course of taking medication prescribed by a doctor. I was told of a medication that would help dissolve the inflamed area. They were Ramadan nights, and there was some way to go get them before suhoor time. Such agony overtook me that I thought I was going through the last moments of my life. I insisted on my family to partake of sahur, thinking that they will all miss it if I ended up dying. I would close my eyes and then open them in this severe discomfort in anticipation of the angel of death's arrival. Has he come? Has he not come? But the pain was due to the inflamed part of the abscess dissolving. Gradually, I got better. The very next day, as per normal practice, I was in the library upstairs, and the door leading to the staircase was closed, when a handsome man appeared in front of me." Subhanallah, ya Allah. "Who are you?" I asked. "I am the one you were waiting during the night last night. I am the one you were waiting during the night," he revealed to him. I said to him, "Then take me away. He replied, not yet. And this was 25 years before his death. Subhanallah. Seeing the angel of death in a dream, when the Sheikh was admitted to hospital during his second visit to Britain, we found his condition very worrying on the second day, and thereby even talked about booking a private flight from London to Medina Tayyiba. But when we put this before the Sheikh upon his arrival at Darul Uloom after regaining his health, he remarked, 'Do not worry about my dying. I am not dying now. A promise has been made to me.'" And very few of us could say that. Who could say, "I'm not dying now"? We're not sure. We could die next minute, next salat, next hour. But he said, "Do not worry about my dying. I am not dying now. A promise has been made to me." He thereafter said, "You will have heard the dream concerning the angel of death. I once fell ill in Makkah Mukarramah. during that period of my illness in Makkah, I saw a handsome young man in a dream appear before me. "Who are you?" I asked. "Ana malakul maut." "I am the angel of death," he said. "Let's go then. Let's go." He said, "Not here. Not here. When you reach Medina Munawwara, I will visit you there." After my journey from Makkah Mukarramah to Medina Munawwara, the angel of death again appeared in my dream. Walking away, the angel of death appeared in my dream, walking away from me. Came in my dream, appeared, but he was walking away. So I said to him, "Well, did you not say, I will visit you when you reach Medina Munawwara? Now I have reached." The angel of death said, laughing, "Some more work is to be taken from you yet." "Not yet. Some more work is to be taken from you yet." Subhanallah. So he remained for some time more in Medina, doing more work and doing more khidmat. Approximately 3 days prior to his death, the sheikh pointed towards the corner of the room. It's 3 days before his death. And the sheikh is pointing towards the corner of the room and said, "Look, look, shaitan is standing there. Can you see him? Can you see him?" As per routine, shaitan had made his way there, something the hadith informs us about. But dare he proceed any further? "Can you see him? He's standing right over there." That's 3 or 4 days prior to his death. Let's go back a little more. 3 or 4 days prior to this incident, Sheikh Najibullah was aiding the Sheikh to relieve himself. I was situated in the room opposite, and it was past 12 o'clock midnight. 2 loud shrieks were heard from outside. "Najibullah! Najibullah!" I rushed outside, but there was no sign of anyone. The exact scenario played out before Pir Sahib Sheikh Talha's mother's eyes also. Upon completing a complete Quran reading and intending to send its reward to someone from the deceased, someone called her name out in a very loud voice. This was despite there being no one who even knew her by name besides only 2 or 3 people of the household. It was certainly a voice from the unseen. Its purpose, only Allah knows, only Allah knows. This was the scenario played out before Pir Sahib Sheikh Talha's mother's eyes. Coming back to the final illness of Hazrat Sheikh Nawarallahu Markadahu Rahimahullah. Dr. Ismail Memon has penned a comprehensive account surrounding the circumstances of the Sheikh's demise. He, Dr. Ismail Memon, writes, "The Sheikh was half conscious on the evening of Sunday, 16th of May, 1982. The next day, he became fully conscious from Fajr onwards, and spent the whole of Sunday in that state. His body remained fixed in whatever position it was moved into. He didn't call out, cough, or do anything. His pulse and blood pressure indicated towards no imminent danger, and treatment and remedial work of other kinds continued. The reading of the whole of Sahihul Bukhari was undertaken, which started on Sunday and was completed in the course of 2 days, Sunday and Monday, which was followed by a very entreating dua made by Sheikh Talha, his son. A completion gathering a khatam of Surah Yasin in Sheikh Muhammad Alawi Al-Maliki's gathering also took place in Makkah Mukarrama. On Monday, the 17th of May, unconsciousness remained, but not as much as the previous day. In fact, he was slightly animated. In the morning, he was uttering, Allah, Allah. And after Zuhar, Ya Arhamar Rahimeen. After Zuhar, Ya Kareem, Ya Kareem, Ya Kareem, O Most Bountiful, Ya Kareem. So in the morning, uttering, Allah, Allah. After Zuhar, Ya Kareem, Ya Kareem. And now and then he would say, O the Most Bountiful, O the Forbearing One, Ya Halim, Ya Kareem. He uttered this from time to time till the end of his life. This useless individual, speaking about himself, Dr. Ismail Memon, consulted other doctors too, especially Dr. Ashraf, Dr. Ayub, Dr. Sultan, Dr. Mansoor, and Dr. Abdul Ahad, whilst Dr. Insiram assisted greatly in inspecting the blood samples and among other things. However, the kidney and the liver function was deteriorating all the time. Blood and urine samples were taken and treatment continued to be administered. Food intake had more or less stopped. Nutrition, water and glucose were being dripped through a vein. The Sheikh performed Juma Salat on that Friday, that Juma, 21st of May, with the Haram Sharif congregation at the main door of Madrasatul Shari'iyya. His demise, the death. His health apparently remained stable up to the morning of Sunday, 23rd of May. However, he experienced breathing problems after Dhuhr Salat on that day, which was immediately treated. When this useless individual, speaking about himself, Dr. Ismail, when this useless individual was at the surgery half an hour prior to Maghrib, the Sheikh's attendant, Sheikh Najibullah, phoned me to say that his health had deteriorated. I therefore returned straight away and saw that he was finding it very difficult to breathe and was in discomfort due to it. After checking him, I gave him an injection, which after a few minutes relaxed him and brought his breathing levels to normal. His condition was relatively fine up to the point of this servant leaving for home after Isha. And he was talking a little as well, though the worrying factor was that he had not passed urine since Zuhar of the previous day. He began having difficulty breathing again at 8 o'clock in the morning. We began working on how he could pass urine, which he eventually did between Zuhar and Asr time. To aid breathing, an injection was given and oxygen, etc., supplied. He experienced discomfort until 12 o'clock in the afternoon, so much so that he would say, sit me up, lay me down, bring the medication every so often. He was also loudly saying, Oh, the Most Bountiful, Oh, the Most Bountiful. Because this useless individual, Dr. Ismail Memon, remained beside him throughout, he would occasionally hold this useless individual's hand and he would press it and press it. When around 11 o'clock, Al-Hajj Abul Hassan lifted the pillow, he looked towards me and said, is it Dr. Sahib? Abul Hassan said, yes, yes, this is Dr. Ismail, this is Dr. Ismail. Hearing this, he smiled at me. This was to be the last conversation of the Sheikh. He thereafter continued uttering, Oh, the Most Bountiful, Oh, the Most Bountiful. This continued Ya Kareem, Ya Kareem, Ya Kareem, Ya Kareem, Ya Kareem, Subhanallah. This continued with his uttering Ya Kareem, Ya Kareem, continued until Zuhar Salat. Then after Zuhar, a complete calmness overtook him, which remained till the end. That calmness remained with him right until the end. This useless individual, speaking about himself, continuously checked the pulse and blood pressure. Prior to the soul leaving his body, Sheikh Talha, Hafizahullah, asked the servant, "Is this the last moment? Is this the last moment Talha is asking me?" This servant nodded his head in agreement. It is the last. So he began uttering, "Allah, Allah," in a loud voice. The Sheikh at this moment hiccuped twice, because of which his eyes closed and the soul departed his body. It was exactly 1740 hours, 1740 hours at the time. 1700 hours, 40 minutes, 1740 hours at the time. That is 1.5 hours before Maghrib Salah. The Sheikh passed away and left for the eternal abode. Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Allahumma ajirna fi musibatina. Allahumma ajirna fi musibatina iwadhan khairan minha. O Allah, grant us in this musibat and difficulty of ours an iwadh, an exchange which is better than it. Allahumma ajirna fi musibatina iwadhan khairan minha. Wa inna bi firaqika ya shaykh la mahzunun. O Sheikh, we are indeed by separation from you so saddened, so saddened. This person who spent his entire life following the sunnah divinely achieved. Allahu Akbar. Look at this. He spent his whole life, this person, following the sunnah. He divinely achieved obedience to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in that he even died in a sunnah way. He even died on a Monday between the time of Asr and the time of Maghrib. Subhanallah. He died on Monday, as Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had died on Monday, the 12th of Rabiul Awal. The state of those present at the time is beyond explanation. Ya Rabbi, Ya Kareem. Present at the time of the death were the Sheikh's son, Sheikh Talha, Sheikh Aqil, his son Jafar, Al-Hajj Abul Hassan, Sheikh Najibullah, Sufi Iqbal, Sheikh Yusuf Motala, Hakim Abdul Quddus, Sheikh Ismail, Sheikh Nadir, Dr. Ayyub, Haji Dildar, As'ad, Abdul Qadir, and this useless individual. Shrouding and burial proceedings. Burial preparations were initiated straight away. Dr. Ayyub was sent to pick up the relevant death certificate from the hospital, while Sheikh Talha, Sheikh Aqil, with close relatives and Sheikh's attendants, consulted one another whether to keep janaza after Isha or after Fajr. It was confirmed that some special loved ones and associates were on their way from Makkah Mukarramah, but their time of leave was already known and their arrival at Isha time was all but guaranteed. It was therefore agreed to have janaza straight after Isha and not delay until Fajr. An announcement of this was made. But Hazrat says, we will always live to regret the fact that the car of those loved ones who we eagerly awaited broke down during the journey, and thereby they did not arrive on time. However, as the announcement had already been made, last minute changes were not possible. Everyone was informed via telephone. The body was washed after Maghrib Salat under the guidance and supervision of Sheikh Akil and Sheikh Yusuf Motala, our own Hazrat Hafizahullah. A large crowd of the Sheikh's attendants was present at the time. Each individual wished to participate in this blessed act. The following names are worthy of mention from the ones who helped wash the body: Sheikh Yusuf Motala, Hafizahullah, Al-Hajj Abul Hassan, Sheikh Najibullah, Hakim Abdul Quddus, Aziz Jafar, Shah Atta Al-Muhaymin, Ibn Sheikh Shah Atta'ullah Bukhari, Sufi Aslam, Sheikh Siddiq, Sheikh Ihsan, Qadi Abrar, and Abdul Majid. Dr. Ayub, who had gone to obtain the certificate, arrived 2 hours later and informed us that there were some legal barriers in obtaining the certificate. Therefore, the Sheikh's son, Sheikh Talha, was asked to accompany him. And those in charge of burial proceedings were asked to start digging the grave. But they declined, saying they cannot dig until the certificate is brought from the hospital. Now, there were only 45 minutes left for Isha Salat. While the digging of the grave by Isha looked seemingly unlikely, it prompted the aforementioned respected individuals to agree to have Janaza Salat after Fajr. But immediately after that, Sayyid Habib arrived saying, "I have shown them the spot where the grave is to be dug, and they have already begun." Then some 20 minutes later, certificate arrived from the hospital, and the news of the grave being ready was received. Those in charge of burial matters also brought over a specific buyer. Thus, the corpse was ready within 15 minutes still to go. The corpse was ready with 15 minutes still to go for the call of Isha Salat for Azan. As initially agreed, the body was taken to the Haram Sharif through the gate of Salam, through Babu Salam. His body was taken through Babu Salam. Straight after the Fard of Isha, as per the norm there, the Imam of the Haram, Sheikh Abdullah Az-Zahim, led the Janaza Salat before it was led to Jannatul Baqi through the gate of Jibril, through Babi Jibril. The crowd was unbelievably large. Such crowding will probably not have been seen for a corpse ever before. Allah's ikram again for him. The crowd was unbelievably large. Such crowding will probably not have been seen for a corpse ever before. As per Hazrat's desire, his grave was dug near the enclosure of Ahlul Bayt, where the family of the noble Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had been laid to rest. His grave was dug near that, and near the grave of his own Sheikh, Hazrat Khalil Ahmad Saharanpuri alayhi rahma. His son, Sheikh Talha, and Al-Hajj Abul Hassan climbed into the grave and closed it. This is how the Sheikh's lifelong wish was fulfilled. Concern for his acquaintances, a notable matter seen was the fact that the Sheikh, one day prior to his passing away, asked everyone individually, "What are you engaging? What is your hal?" He asked Sufi Iqbal, Al-Hajj Abul Hassan, and he asked this useless individual directly. As his son Sheikh Talha was in another room, he asked his Qadim to go and ask him as to what he was doing. As each reply mentioned some form of litany, some form of dhikr, tilawat, he remained quiet. When he asked the servant, Abul Hassan answered before the servant could even answer. He said, "He will now leave for hospital. He will now leave for surgery and cure the sick." The Sheikh said, is that even a thing to do? Anyhow, it shows that he showed concern for his acquaintances even in his last moments as to what they were doing. Glad tidings, subhanallah, glad tidings. Lam yabqa min an-nubuwat illa al-mubashirat. Nothing remains of nubuwat and prophethood illa al-mubashirat, except the glad tidings. What are the glad tidings? Al-bushra. It is a ru'ya saliha, a pious dream that a person sees and he is informed about the unseen. Allahu Akbar. After the burial, a disciple who is also a khalifa of Hazrat Sheikh Maulana Zakariyya, after the janazah, burial is finished, a disciple and khalifa of the Sheikh dreamt that someone is saying, فُتِحَ لَهُ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ الثَّمَانِيَةِ فُتِحَ لَهُ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ الثَّمَانِيَةِ The 8 doors of Jannah have been opened up unto him. فُتِحَ لَهُ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ الثَّمَانِيَةِ Another individual, while invoking salawat and blessings at the blessed grave of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam the next day, as he was before Rasulullah, before his grave, sending Darul, he sensed as if the messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying to him, your sheikh has been given a place in the highest heavens. Your sheikh has been given a place in the highest heavens. Very few from many a million human beings is of such caliber at the blessed grave of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Khalifa of Hazrat Sheikh sensed these words from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this Allahumma is how he left. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ Allahumma ahina muslimin wa amitna muslimin. Inshallah, tomorrow, Hazrat writes about the passing away of his own brother, Maulana Abdul Rahim's demise. Tomorrow, inshallah. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Nashhadu wa la ilaha illa anta. Nastaghfiruk wa natubu ilayk. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Salamun alal mursaleen walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Social expectation drowns us all inside. What you have should be what I want, 'cause what I have just ain't alright.